science lesson, that too chemistry. In our everyday life, like day and night, seasonal changes, like this. So now I will be going to give some examples. I want you all to say what kind of change it is. So now we all know water, the state of water is liquid. When we refrigerate the water, what happens?
Solid.
It will become ice. It converts into ice. If we take out from the refrigerator ice cube, what happens? It melts. So what form we will get again?
Liquid.
Again liquid form we will get water. So water converts into ice and ice to water. So now just observe carefully. I am going to just show you I am holding the rubber band. Observe the size and shape. I am going to put a pressure either side. I am going to expand. What happens to the size and shape of the rubber?
It changes.
Is the size length was being increased now?
Yes.
Is the size shape remain same?
No.
No. Now I will release. Did we got the original size and shape?
Yes.
Now you observe two changes. Two examples. One I said water to ice and expanding the rubber. What kind of changes these two are?
Physical
changes. They're reversible changes. So the physical changes will be these two. Now I'll show you the other example. Observe carefully. Can you just by looking at this water or the material which is inside, you can guess what it is?
Milk.
Curd?
Milk.
Milk. Confusion. So at least by curd or milk, by the smell we can detect, right? I'll show you the smell.
Curd.
Okay, fine. So she has assured that it is a curd. How do we obtain curd?
Curding of the milk.
Yeah, why you are laughing? It is the curding of the milk. So in order to get curd, we need to do the curding of the milk only. Fine. So can we get back milk from this curd?
No.
So then what kind of change it is?
Irreversible
change. What do we call for that irreversible change?
Chemical change.
So turning of milk into curd is an example for milk turning to curd is an example for chemical change. It is also called irreversible. Now, I will show you another one example you all need to observe. See, I just have taken the bits of paper and holder. I am going to supply heat to this.
Burning.
Paper is burning. Why? How do you make out this is burning?
Because
you can see the flames. Can you all see the smoke also? It's relaying, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Why did I hold this in a holder instead of my bare fingers?
It may cause burn.
It causes heat. That means while burning paper, it releases heat also along with the flame. So what kind of, can I get back the paper from this?
No.
Surely not. Then what kind of change it is?
It's also irreversible.
Burning of paper is an example for chemical change. See, here there is a candle. I'm going to lit the candle. Yes. So now just I lit the candle. How did I lit the candle? It's so simple question, right? Just I supplied the heat. Now candle is burning. How do you make out candle is burning?
We can see the flame.
We can see the flame. Okay. Can I touch the flame?
No.
Why? It is the heat. So it will get hot. Now what kind of change it is? Is it candle keep burning? Is it candle wax remains?
No.
It will get evaporates. So we won't get back the candle from this. So what kind of change we can notice here?
This is also a chemical.
It is a chemical change again. So what we call irreversible. Can we call it as a chemical reaction?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now even this here also we can find some chemical reaction. And in other cases also we can find in our day-to-day life variety of chemical changes or chemical reactions. But the two other examples I conducted showed you here, there is something unique compared to other chemical reactions. Like maybe metals reacting with oxygen, iron reacts with oxygen, forms rusting. All this we will come across. But in this kind of examples, where we will find flame, after the reaction, in the process of reaction, we will find flame and which also releases heat. What do we call such kind of reactions?
Combustion.
Okay, is a process wherever the combustible substances burns, when you supply heat, those reactions are called combustion. So in today's class, let us learn about the, in detail about the meaning and components of combustion. In the lesson, combustion and flame. Meaning and components of flame.